Hello, and welcome back to Math 301 Combinatorics at Colorado State University. Today's topic is triangular numbers. So triangular numbers are a very famous set of numbers in combinatorics. They come up a lot. And one problem they come up in is, and where they get their name from, is how many dots are in a triangular grid, defined by taking a big triangle and cutting it up into lots of little triangles in the way that you see there, and counting how many dots are there. So there's a number of ways to approach this. One is to just count them. As you see, the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are appearing on the dots. This is how you might count them, you know, left to right in each row is a good way to organize it. We're at 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. So that's a bit of a laborious way of counting them, but certainly you can do it for this size. But what if it's a bigger triangle? It might take you very long to do this. We might want an efficient way of computing how many dots are in such a triangular grid. So another way of organizing our work is counting them by row. So there's one dot in the first row, and then two in the next row, and three in the row after that. Every row contains one more dot than the previous row. So we could have just added up the numbers from 1 to 6 here, and again, we would get 21 if you compute that out. So in general, a triangular number for any number of rows can be defined as the sum of the numbers 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to n for some n. And our goal today is to find a formula for the triangular numbers and figure out how it's applicable, where it comes up in combinatorics, and why it's so nice. So this is an example of a triangular number, the sixth, and an easier way we could have added these numbers together from 1 to 6 is by adding the first and the last. 1 and 6 gets 7, the second and second to last, 2 plus 5 is also 7, and 3 plus 4 is also 7. So we get 3 7s, and we could have just computed 3 times 7 to get 21. Now this trick works very well for a case of having an even number of rows, but for an odd number of rows, it breaks down a little bit. So say we had 5 rows and we were just computing the sum of the numbers from 1 to 5, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. If we pair the first and the last and the second to the second to last, we do get 6, but then the 3 is just half of that because the 3 can't pair with anything, it's by itself. And so what we get is something slightly different in the even and odd case if we just naively try to pair things like this, but there's a more general way we can approach it. And it leads to what's called Gauss's formula. So Gauss, the famous mathematician Gauss, when he was a child, his teacher asked him to add up all the numbers from 1 to 100. And he didn't feel like doing it just by adding them one at a time, so he came up with this formula that the sum of the numbers from 1 to n, the triangular number, is n times n plus 1 divided by 2. And the way to prove this in general is to add the sum to itself. This avoids the even and odd case issue. So if you take the numbers 1 to n and you add the sum to itself backwards, n plus n minus 1 plus n minus 2 down to 1, added up, you know, added to the original sum 1 through n, then if you add the columns organized this way, 1 plus n gives you n plus 1, 2 plus n minus 1 also gives you n plus 1, 3 plus n minus 2 is n plus 1. You keep getting n plus 1. And how many n plus 1s did we get? Well, there are n numbers in the sequence 1 through n, so there are n n plus 1s in our final result. So the final total summation here is n times n plus 1, but we added the sum to itself twice. So we want to divide by 2 in the end to get the answer that we were looking for. And that's how you get the formula n times n plus 1 divided by 2. So there's Gauss's formula and a nice proof of it. There are many different proofs that we'll see throughout this class. But what I want to say today is just some applications of this in combinatorics. So here's a famous application called the handshake problem. So suppose there are 5 people in a room and everybody shakes hands with everybody exactly once so that they all meet each other. The question is, how many handshakes happened? So one way of visually representing this problem is with what's called a graph. A graph has nodes and edges. So the nodes here are going to represent the people. Nodes are just drawn as dots, and we often label the nodes. So let's label the people A, B, C, D, and E. And then a handshake between the people can be represented as what's called an edge of the graph, which is just a segment connecting two of the dots. And so you can see we A shook hands with B, C, D, and E, and then B has to shake hands with C, D, and E. Everybody shakes hands with everybody else exactly once, so we're just going to draw an edge between every single pair of vertices in this graph. this graph that has all the edges drawn is called a complete graph, and there's a complete graph for any number of vertices. So the handshake problem can be rephrased as saying, how many edges are in a complete graph? In this case, in 5 vertices. So let's add them up. Let's start with how many people did A shake hands with? 4, B, C, D, and E. Once we've counted those, we want to count how many did B shake hands with that weren't already A. We don't want to count the segment between A and B twice. So we just say B shook hands with C, D, and E, which is 3 more. So 3 more handshakes besides A. Then C contributes 2 more handshakes besides the ones that already shook with A and B, and D contributes 1 more. And finally, E has now at this point shaken hands with everybody, so they don't have to shake hands with anybody else besides A, B, C, and D. So in total, we get 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1 handshakes plus 0. And that is a triangular number. That's the 4th triangular number. So plugging in n equals 4 into our formula, we get 4 times 4 plus 1, which is 5, divided by 2. And 4 times 5 is 20. Divide that by 2, we get 10. Now, we could have also just counted the 10 edges on this graph, but this gives you a general way of computing the number of edges in any complete graph. If we had more people, how many handshakes are there? It's always n times n plus 1 over 2 if there were n plus 1 people. Here's another example of something fun you can do with Gauss's formula. You can compute other sums of other large sequences besides just adding the numbers from 1 to n. For instance, say we wanted to add the even numbers between 2 and 100. Well, it might look like it's a completely different problem at first, but when you look at it, you realize we can factor a 2 out of that entire sum and turn it back into a triangular number problem. So if you factor out a 2, you get 2 times the sum of the numbers from 1 up to 50. And the sum of the numbers from 1 up to 50 by Gauss's formula is 50 times 51 divided by 2. Now, the 2's cancel in this multiplication problem, and we just get 50 times 51, which is 2,550, which is a quite efficient way of adding up all the even numbers. You can similarly add up multiples of 3 or multiples of any number. Here's another thing you can do, and this is something for you to try. Compute the sum of the numbers from 10 up to 100. So this is the quiz problem at the end of this video. And the hint here is we can use Gauss's formula to add up all the numbers from 1 to 100 and then subtract off the sum from 1 to 9. So lots of interesting sequences here we can add, and we will see you next time with more combinatorics.